This is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self. The following video clip features an audio segment from a Higher Self channeling session that I had with a member of this YouTube audience. During this session, I was asked questions to describe the Higher Self experience and other related topics, such as meditating upon the spiritual heart, the current ascension and 2012 experiences happening within humanity, deeper insights into the mind, emotions, the state of meditation, and many other topics that relate to these channel Higher Self videos. The following video is one clip of 37 separate videos organized according to topics. The total video time is over 2 hours and 20 minutes. You can find a list of these video topics along with their respective links on the sidebar to the YouTube video and also in the description on the on my channel Higher Self website. So I'd like to thank you for taking part in these Higher Self videos with me, and I would like to wish you many blessings and much love within your life. Namaste.
The spiritual heart's interesting. It starts as an energy just localized within the heart, like the heart chakra would be. But the spiritual heart, when more awakened, it grows. And like you said in your experience in meditation, this feeling of who you are grows, and it grows from the heart, and it's this feeling of love and peace and bliss. And like I'm feeling it right now, and all my cells are starting to vibrate. And you feel this love, and it just keeps expanding, and it fills your entire aura, and then it just keeps expanding beyond the field of your aura out into the universe. So the spiritual heart, it's not limited to the location of your physical heart or the heart chakra. When it's awakened more, it fills everywhere and everything. And when you meditate upon it, you will feel yourself expand, and you'll be without physical feeling boundaries. You won't feel within your body anymore. You won't feel within your energy aura anymore. And yeah, it's really amazing that it's you know, it begins in your heart, but it extends to infinity. And you can feel that like right now, you can feel it any time. And it's an amazing healing energy. Because as you're feeling this love, your entire body is being bathed in this love. You're feeling, all your cells feel this bliss and this happiness. And the mind will be completely silent, or it will quiet more until eventually it will get silent. And this feeling of love just becomes you. And it's completely peaceful, completely satisfying, and the mind's completely quiet. And there's no more desires. If you notice, the mind stops and no desires come about. There's no thoughts to do anything else. And when this happens, this is the Buddhic state. This is the state beyond desire. It's not that we need to move through time and space and complete our desires. What the Buddha meant was that when we meditate and we enter into this state of universal consciousness, of universal love, there are no desires. The desires cease to exist. And we may return back to the ego mind and the desires may start up again. But in the experience of the higher self consciousness, desires do not exist. So this is the state beyond suffering. This is the direct experience of the Buddhic state. It is taught in some traditions that you must work through your desires, you must eliminate your desires, and it's an ongoing struggle in the religious participants, in the members of the organization, to try to get rid of their desires, to remove their desires, and they fight with the ego. And it's actually the ego fighting with the ego because of a wrong belief. The belief is wrong. It's wrong to think that the ego must remove the desires from the ego. But the person who's identified with the mind doesn't see it like that. They're still identified with the ego, so they can't see beyond it yet. And so essentially they believe that they must remove the desires from their mind, when it's really the mind that's thinking this. So that is why I say ignore the mind, ignore the ego, and just connect with the heart. Connect with the feeling of love. And then you will be taken into the direct experience of the condition beyond desire. You'll be taken directly into that Buddhic state. And that's when you'll understand that what the Buddha was talking about was an experience of non-desire. It's not the process of removing desire. It's immediately stepping into the experience of having no desire. And that's when there's no more suffering. And that's the experience of this love, of this peace, of this bliss, this expansion into the universal consciousness. And then the more fully we're able to enter into this, the more the ego quiets, the more the mind quiets, the more we feel love, the more we experience a connection to wisdom, of deep inner silent knowing, the more creative energy we have, the more we see our manifestations happen instantly, because we realize that there is just this oneness, and we are that.